Alright, welcome back everybody to Alone, the Long Dark. This is episode 2. We last left off in the Grey Mother's house in Milton. So, let us take a look around. You know what, I think I'm going to drop that skin in that gut that I harvested last time. Alright, let's go outside and take a look around and see what we can find. Alright. Now, one of my favorite survivalists, Les Stroud, used to say, always take into account your zones of survival. And, oh, there's a wolf. Where is he? You know what, I'm gonna go back in the house. As I was saying, one of my favorite survivalists, Les Stroud, Survivor Man, used to say, always take into account your zones of survival. First, you should consider everything that's on your person. Then you expand your radius. You look in your circle immediate vicinity. And then you expand again. So today we're going to kind of expand our circle and see what we can find in not necessarily the immediate vicinity, but relatively close. Probably right here within what I can see from the Grey Mother house. Okay. I think that wolf is gone. So. Let's go over here and check these vehicles. Nothing in the back of the truck. Can't open the trunk. Nothing. Not a thing. All right. Let's go into the bank. See what we find. Maybe we'll find something in here. I don't know. It's a bank. There's not usually much in a bank. Maybe some cash for some tender. We'll see. See what we can find. Some tender. It's not the brightest in here, but I don't think I really want to waste a match or light a torch just to see, because I can see pretty... Ooh, lockers. Hey. They're both open, but lacking any goods.
This will come in handy.
Ah, some antiseptic. Ooh, work boots. Oh, that's good. Better replace my tennis shoes. They are a little bit warmer. They are not in very good condition. That's okay. Take water. My philosophy is take as much water as I can possibly carry, because when I have limited matches or limited fire, it's means I have the ability to make limited water. So, oh, some more.
I think I can use
There's a windbreaker. I'll put that on. Cover up those arms. But yeah, the more water you have, the better. That way I don't have to make it. Although I do have a pot, so when I want to make water, I can make a lot of water at a time. Ah, coffee. I love coffee. Me as a person, not even as just a character. Okay. Oh, hey, there's a dead guy. Oh, and a knife. Cash? He must have been trying to rob the place. Okay, let's crack this safe. Wow. to go all the way around like that. Gosh, it's all the way back around too. And there it is. Okay. Tumblr 2. Now let's see where Tumblr 3 is. I wish real locks were this easy to crack. Okay, so I passed that, so it was, what, like 59? Then all the way back around to like 2 or something like that. And then I think it was like 35 or something for that third one. Ah, 32. There it is. Okay. So we got it.
I hope nobody needs this anymore.
Oh, mucklucks. Okay, I'm going to replace those bark roots with 96% mucklucks. Wow, that is an amazing find. My feet are going to be so toasty warm. I can't believe I found mucklucks. That's a hard find on... I normally play Stalker, so this is kind of in between Stalker and Interloper. And mucklucks are even really hard to find in Stalker mode. At least the times that I've played. Okay, I think I'm done. I think I'm done at the bank. Wow, I don't think a bank has ever been this good to me. I've never found this much good stuff when I walked into a bank, you know, in real life. Yeah. My bank account's always pretty low. So, all right. So we've taken care of the bank. Now, there was a shed over here. That was sort of in the immediate vicinity. And I'm thinking there might be some tools over in the shed over here. But yeah, we got some little houses here. Let's check these out. Okay, maybe not houses. Outbuildings. Here's some big outbuildings. That's what they are. Okay, toolbox here. I apologize for my kids in the background. You can hear them. Another knife. Two knives. I'm sure you can hear my children in the background. Not much I can do about that. I don't have a little studio that I can record in a soundproof studio, so. Okay. Where are we gonna go next? You know what? No. I think. There's the shadow. That's what I wanna go to. Stick. Sticky sticks. Ha! Hatchet. Wait, that's my second hatchet. Is that my second hatchet? Did you find a hatchet earlier? I think I did. That's okay. I'll take them. Right now, I'm not worried about encumbrance because I've got almost nothing. No clothing. Clothing is what really takes up most of the weight in your inventory. So, I'm not really worried about weight yet. I'll just pick up whatever, and then I'll find a place to stash it. And it's dark in here. It's very dark in here. Go ahead and search these cabinets, see if I can find some more food. Because right now, I don't have any way of getting food other than rabbits. So, hopefully I will, hopefully I'll find some food to get me through the next night, because I think we got nightfall coming up soon. And then maybe I'll go out hunting for rabbits tomorrow. A whole tin of coffee. Speaking of coffee, I think I'm going to have a drink of coffee because my tired meter is low. Tired meter? I don't know. I'm pretty tired. So pick me up, just kind of finish searching what I can of this house before I go take a nap. Socks, I'll put those on. And I'll take some more water. Oh, I just realized I can hit X to take it all. I don't know why I've never noticed that before. the things you learn every time you play this game. Anyway, one thing I want to just kind of say here, disclaimer, is I'm not a survival expert. I watch a lot of survival shows, and so I'm kind of applying some of those things that I've learned watching those shows to me playing this game. Oh, was that, that scared me there. It was like a baby in the crib. Ooh, a dead baby. It's a bear. It's a teddy bear. Okay. Oh, sewing kit. That's good. Another can of spray paint. Okay. So, let's see. What's going out? Since I just had a shot of coffee, I'm not incredibly tired, although it is evening, it is getting dark. Let's go ahead and mark this house. I've searched this. I've got everything out of it I want to get out of it. So, this is the big piece of this update, which is really kind of fun. I can mark this house too, because I already searched that. That way I don't come back later and go back through them and waste a bunch of time, since I know that I searched them. And rather than having to use charcoal to make your map, when you mark things, it shows it on the map. Doesn't show you a big area. They did do some changes with the mapping system. Oh my goodness. I got a rifle. Okay. That is a game changer, folks. And a cartridge. Dog. Two more cartridges.
What are we here?
Oh my goodness. Okay. So this is a game changer for me. Now I don't have to rely solely on rabbits and found food. I can go out and hunt. And if a pesky wolf gets too close, I could take him out. But I only have like 3 rounds, so I'm going to save those. Maybe go hunt some deer tomorrow. Mark that truck as having been searched. Oh, I can't believe I found a rifle and cartridges. So that that doesn't ever happen in Interloper, because there are no rifles. But even in Stalker, finding a gun can be really difficult. But I haven't played here in Milton in a long time, so I really didn't know what was in here. So I'm kind of exploring, just like Jonas would, having never been here before. And being amazed at what he found. Okay. So after I found that rifle, got some soda, a flare, good. Man, getting some really good loot here. What was I saying? Yeah, after having found that rifle, I am now encumbered, because it weighs a lot. But I also know that I have those pair of shoes and a pair of boots that I took off that's weighing me down. Let's check the post office. Let's see what's in the post office here. Probably nothing.
I'm gonna take this food.
Oh, that's 22% condition. I'm going to go ahead and eat that. It's really important, I think, to at least for the in this game, to check the condition of the food when you pick it up. Because if it's getting close to 20%, eat it. If it's below 20%, I won't eat it, because I've made too many mistakes and gotten sick by eating something that was 19% condition. So I'm not going to do that. All right. I'm thinking that it's time for me to maybe sort of establish a home base. So yeah, let's go down this way, see what we got over here. A house? No, this is another storage building. Alright, I'm just adding my weight. I'm going to have to do something about that soon. But right now, there's so much stuff. So much stuff in this town to look at and loot. And as long as I've got daylight and I'm not exhausted, I'm going to keep looking. Is there seriously nothing in this building? Absolutely nothing except that one piece of reclaimed wood? Okay. Let's mark this house. Keeping an eye out for wolves. It's kind of close quarters here, and I don't want one to wander in on me and eat me before I could get my rifle out. See if there's any containers in this old burned out house. Sometimes there are. Nope. Man, I can't believe I found mucklucks and a rifle in this episode. That's pretty amazing. But, you know, with all a good fortune, misfortune will also come, and I hear a lot of wolves, so, gosh. Make sure they're not sneaking up on me here. Let's see what we found in here. There go my kids again. I can hear them over my headphones, so I know they're being loud, and I know that you can hear them as well. I don't know if you've noticed my pattern. There's another cooking pot. Let's see. Do I have one? Yeah, I got one. I don't think I'm going to take that. It's heavy, and I've already got one, so I'm not going to take it. But I have a pattern when I search kitchens and stuff. I like to do all the bottom cabinets first, everything on the bottom, and then go to everything on the top. I don't know why. I just do. That way I kind of know when I get to the end of a row. I've got all the cabinets in that section, and then I can move up to the top. Man, it's getting really, really dark in here. Okay. So, I am probably going to spend the night in here, since it is so dark. And I don't have a light source. Yeah. So, well, I got a torch, but I don't want to waste matches. Alright. Yeah, so let's go ahead and, while we've got a little bit of light left, let's harvest these shoes for the leather. Because that leather is going to be really important for keeping those. Yep, that's what I'm saying, buddy. Leather is going to be really important to keep those mucklucks in good condition. So I'll harvest those. It's a long time to harvest these boots. But the great thing about harvesting is that you can do it in the dark. You can do it in the dark. Let's go ahead and drink a soda pop. Thirsty. Calories running low. Let's drink another one. Drink the grape soda. Oh. Man, I'm getting tired. Let's see. Okay. So, checking my calories here. I got 1,400 calories. That's plenty of calories. Let's top off my thirst meter here, make sure I don't deplete that when I sleep, because I'm just going to go ahead and sleep through the whole night. Sometimes I'll sleep for like 6 hours at a time, just to make sure I don't run out of water. I'm going to go ahead and just go for 11 hours. And good thing I didn't go any longer. Oh, and a pair of trail boots. Okay, so I harvested my shoes and those work boots. I'm going to hang on to these trail boots because normally I like to have two sets of everything. I like to keep one in reserve because, you know, if I happen to get attacked by a wolf or a bear, which tends to do a lot more damage. Let's mark this house as being searched. Way up high, so I can see. If I get attacked by a wolf or a bear, they can ruin your clothing. And yeah, I can make deer hide boots if I need to, but it's always a good idea just to have something in reserve, stuck in storage somewhere that, hey, it got ruined, okay, I've got this other pair of boots that I can go grab and put them on. So I'm going to hang on to those trail boots instead of harvesting them.
This will come in handy.
And there's another cooking pot. You know what? I'll take it. Why not? If I establish a base somewhere, I'll leave one there at the base, and I'll take the other one with me in case I get stranded. Although, I'm not going to be straying too far from town just yet, because the one thing I don't have is a bedroll, which means I can't go sleeping out in the wilds.
I can always use more food.
Stomp, stomp, bang, bang, right? Yeah, that's a four-year-old for you. Four-year-old boy. Stomping, stomping, banging, banging. I'll have to go check on him here in a little
bit. That'll come handy.
Which means I will probably go ahead and end this episode. Here's a dresser. I'm severely, severely overburdened at this point, even after having rested, you know, so that means that it's time to get rid of some stuff. So let's see, I got 28 pounds of tools. I can get rid of that empty spray can, 15 pounds of food. Okay, so there's all my clothes. That's not a lot of weight there. Some weight in fire starting. But most of my weight is in those tools. And I've got two hatchets, two knives, and a rifle. I don't need all of those. I don't need to be lugging all that around. And, of course, water. I got a lot of weight in water. So I think I'm going to go and establish a home base and drop some of this stuff off in storage. Let me write. That's weird. Let me mark it on the door. So let's spray it there. And check this car on the way out here. I think I'm gonna head up to the gas station and make my base there. Being on the edge of town, it's still close enough to town. I can come back once I find a pry bar. I can come back without too much difficulty and search all of these trunks and everything. But it's far enough outside of town that there might be some rabbits. There might be some deer around. So I don't have to go too far on hunting trips. And that's important. Because until I am well protected from the elements, I don't want to venture too far away from shelter where I can get warm. Keep an eye out for wolves after they're howling here. I don't see any though. Excuse me. somebody X'd out the sign there. Maybe they already searched it. I doubt it. There's no. So, you'll notice that a lot of what I've searched, there's been really nothing there. But I have managed to find some really good loot. Wait a minute, that door is locked. Oh, it's back. I'll go in this way. Okay. No! Okay. I don't know if it's always been that way. But if it has, I forgot that it was locked. So, I guess I can't make this my home base unless there's a pry bar in here. Maybe there's a pry bar in here. Oops. Rats. Okay, I guess I'm not going to make that my home base since I can't even get in. Okay, well, I'm going to go back to the grandmother's house. And I'm going to drop some stuff off there. And I think I'm going to call it an episode once I get back there. Alright, so, next episode, I will probably go down the other path. I'll go check out that house up down here on top of that hill. I'll go down this other road over here, loot that, and I'm probably going to start thinking about hunting next time, because I have a rifle. Some rabbits, tan some hides, and make a hat and some mittens. I'm set on my boots though, huh? Don't need to worry about my boots. Yeah. That's good. Alright, so let's head on over here to the storage cabin. Spare knife, my spare hatchet, and gun in, and probably my pot. And that's gonna be it. I'm gonna exit. I'm gonna leave the house and come back in to make sure that it's saved. Put my trail boots in there too, because I want to keep those for sure. And that's gonna be it. So thanks for tuning in. I managed to survive another day and find some awesome stuff. This has been great. Let's go ahead and eat these porky beans. 31%. And I have a knife, so I'm not going to lose any when I open it. It took me a long time to realize that in this game, you don't have to have a can opener. You can use a knife without losing it. All right, so I'm going to go outside. I'll turn around, come back in, and save. And we're going to call this an episode. Once again, thanks for watching. I'm going to be doing these as often as I can. Only takes me, you know, half an hour of gaming, but then it probably takes me an hour to go back in and make sure that everything is situated right and all the sound is correct. So thanks for watching.